All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my Fallout 4 mod spotlight series, where today we are having a look at the Dread Headgear Pack V1D mod, which is being released by user NCRRanger5X, and what this glorious little piece of work looks to add into the game is a seriously impressive pack of new helmets for you to enjoy. And I gotta say, I love every single one of them. In total, you do get 10 new helmets, though the majority of them are sort of various themes off of either opened or closed versions of a singular kind of helmet, but overall they are pretty impressive with some really good models and really good textures to boot, as you can quite clearly see by all the helmets I have set up on these mannequins right here. Now we'll take a closer look at each of them in a moment, but first let's actually go over how you get your hands on all 10 of these helmets. And it's simple-ish. I say ish because, well, you do have to go all the way down to the Glowing Sea and head to the Crater of Adam. Now I'm gonna show you some video right here of me collecting these helmets earlier, and basically once there you just need to head into the main structure in the center and head to an expert locked safe which will have all 10 of the helmets inside of it, and not just one, but in fact two copies of each. So all in all, you get 20 cool helmets to enjoy, which is wonderful. Now, as for the helmets in question, let's actually go ahead and take a look at them on the mannequins here. And I say to do it that way because, well, if we actually go over to the apparel section like we normally do, unfortunately, the model in here isn't updated. So we're gonna look at them in the world as you can see them here. And the first helmet we have is the Chopper helmet, which actually has some pretty decent protection. Not exactly the greatest, but then again, it is a motorcycle helmet, and it will give you 39 defense plus 1 perception. And overall is a just cool looking helmet. I love the detailing to it, very good texturing. You gotta love the spiky bits on the top, and of course, the yellow bird on the side, very cool. My one issue with this one, which is also the same issue I have with this helmet here, is the chin strap. As you can see, whether you're on the female model or the male model, the chin strap kinda goes pretty far below the neck, and since it's rigid, it just looks like an odd plastic holder of sorts, which is a little strange, but overall, thanks to the cool helmet, I can pretty much live with it. Now, as for the other helmet here, this one is the Rebel helmet, and it's one of my favorites in the pack, just because it looks so freaking cool. I really, really do like the texturing on this one, and of course, the lovely eye protection there, very cool. Now this one will give you a little bit more defense with 42, but also still with 1 perception. Now moving on to the next helmets here, let's take a look at this one, which is the Steampunk Gas Mask Gray Closed. Now quickly, as you can see, this mannequin, this mannequin, this mannequin, and this one all are pretty much the same. We just have 2 different color schemes for that steampunk gas mask, and either open face or closed. Now the gray one here we'll start out with, as you can see, does have 33 defense and 260 radiation protection, which is pretty awesome, as well as that 1 perception like with the other helmets so far. Then with the open model, we get slightly less radiation protection. So we got 33 physical, 90 radiation, cause well, the face mask is open. It kind of makes sense that it's not going to be protecting you quite as well. And then we go over to this model, which is again the same stats, so 33 defense, 90 on the radiation and 1 perception, just a different color scheme for the steampunk, a bit more classic steampunk, which is pretty cool. And then of course we go back to a closed faced one, back to the 260 radiation protection, which is wonderful to have. And overall, I mean, just look at that gorgeous steampunky thing. It's glorious. Now the next set of 4 are referred to as insectoid masks. And again, we have sort of the two color scheme, so the sort of beige color scheme, or brownish rather, and then the darker gray slash black, and again in either open or closed. Now let's take a look at this end, and of course start with the insectoid gas mask open, which this one has a little bit extra defense here. We got 33 physical, 50 poison resistance, there we go, and 120 radiation. So not as good on the radiation as of the closed one, again, because we are open, but this one does give you more radiation protection than the steampunk ones we were just looking at, and on top of that, the insectoids give you a little bit of additional intelligence along with perception, which is wonderful. Now, of course, with the closed insectoid, we get 33 physical, 50 poison, and 340 radiation, along with the 1 perception and intelligence, and it just looks magnificent. Look at just the detailing on the sides of this thing. I really, really do love this gas mask, helmet rather, though technically also a gas mask, and it is pretty cool. Now, of course, the next one is the dark variant of the open insectoid gas mask, back down to 33, 50, 120, but the same points in perception and intelligence. And finally, my personal favorite of the entire pack, the dark insectoid gas mask closed. Great stats, again, similar to the regular insectoid gas mask, and just looks amazing. And you guys know me, I love the marine combat armor that I wear pretty much every episode. It's my favorite armor in the game, and guess what? It actually works pretty well with the insectoid mask. It blends pretty nicely. Granted, so does, in fact, the regular dark version of the gas mask. It also... Nope, that's the insectoid one still. The closed gray. There we go. Perfect. Also does work pretty darn well. But really, I mean, come on. The insectoid version is just so cool. Now, one unfortunate problem with this mod that I have is that even though we have all these 10 awesome new helmets, not a single one of them can be upgraded here in the armor workbench. So all I have available is my Assault Marine armor, none of the new helmets, which saddens me a bit. I would love to add some lining to these things or something along those lines just to make it that much better. But oh well, I mean, all in all, these helmets on their own are impressive, especially the insectoid one, again, definitely being my favorite. It's got beautiful stats, some great boosts to perception and intelligence, and just looks simply amazing. So yeah, if you'd like to check out this mod for yourself, which I would definitely recommend that you go and do, you can take a look at the link in the description as per usual. But that is gonna be it for today. I hope you all have enjoyed, and of course, that you do come back for the next episode, when hopefully we'll be looking at yet another wonderful mod. But until that time, thank you for watching, and as always, have a good one!